It happened during the break between the first and the second season. I got cast in the Green Berets with John Wayne. And so I went off to Georgia to shoot that on location. But before I took off, Gene gave me a stack of scripts for the second season. I'd been lobbying him all during the first season for more for Sulu to do, to involve more organically into the plot. And he kept promising that he'd do it, but it'd have to be for the second season.
What? Who?
Fate would have it. We had horrible weather while we were shooting, and we got way over schedule. Couldn't get back in time for the beginning of the second season. And so another actor was brought in to take those wonderful lines and wonderful scenes that were written for me, for Sulu. And I was still off in Georgia, missing out on episode after episode of Star Trek. It was this young actor, Walter Koenig. Never met him, hated him with a passion, with a sight unseen, I hated the guy. I hated Walter Koenig.
Good, honest hatred. Very refreshing.
Sight unseen, I hated him with a passion.
Trent.
I hated the guy. Never met him.
Chekhov.
Chekhov.
And when I finally came back, went to my dressing room, I discovered that I was sharing my dressing room with this hateful young actor. I was livid.
The alien's directly in our line of flight.
Well, I was the helmsman the first season, and I was the helmsman the second season. But the second season, I had this nemesis of mine, Walter Koenig, playing this Russian with this Prince Valiant wig on as a navigator sitting right next to me. From that shared dressing room, we talked intensely for a long time and got to know a lot about each other. We both went to UCLA, and I knew his wife before he married her. She was a classmate at UCLA. And we found a lot of things in common with each other. So out of that blossomed one of the best friendships I have from Star Trek.
A rose is a rose by any other name. Okay. That had to do with a very beautiful guest star named Barbara Boucher.
Oh, you are trying to seduce me.
Character's name was Hanar, from the planet Kevlon, I believe. And we were a society that had taken human form. We started out as aliens in human form, and the human form gradually changed our character, and we became more and more human, and then we lost our initiative to do what we were doing, and they won us over. Each one of us, Kevlons, were approached by in different ways by the various members of the crew. Dr. Bones did a thing with me. I think he kept injecting me with the equivalent of speed. Because I kept getting hyper and hyper and hyper from a very cool kind of guy.
Rojan, I want to talk to you.
Very well.
First, I do not like the way responsibility and duty has been portioned out to us.
It's the way your duties have always been
assigned. That is my second quarrel with you.
Hanar!
Further, I do not care much for the way you run this ship.
Hanar, confine yourself to your quarters.
Did something to another crew member, kept giving him alcohol.
Here's your glass.
Kirk, of course, went after the girl, and so she discovered what love was.
Let me try.
It was also a lot of fun. I got to play an alien in this one and a crew member in the other one.